So you're gonna have to pardon the audio quality on this video because since I'm in the process of moving, I don't know where I put my things because I usually have like drawers to put everything in and like different like sets and stuff, but I have no idea where I put my mic. So today the audio quality is going to be a little on the sketchy side. Hopefully it's not too bad. I'll compensate by like speaking extra loud. I'm like mildly frustrated that I can't find it. Anyway, I digress. But today's episode of The Honest Truth is going to be my community college experience. I feel like it's really important to destigmatize attending community college because it's honestly a really great and affordable option for higher education within the United States. And the most of the people in my life went straight into a four-year university right out of high school. But then you realize in-state tuition, even after 4 years, costs over $100,000. So it's like, do I really want to be a financial burden on either my family or myself for 4 years? I'm a huge advocate for community college, and I don't think that it should be stigmatized as much as it is. It really bothers me when people are like, oh, you go to community college? It's like, yeah, I go to community college, and I'm proud of it. My professors have PhDs from University of Chicago and USC. They're researchers at JPL. They're doing amazing, fantastic things. And the quality of education that I'm getting here is just as great as it is at a four-year university. So it's like, the only thing I don't lose is money, you know? So my community college experience. So I graduated high school and I went to community college because I didn't get into the schools that I wanted to get into straight out of high school. I have more information about like that in my previous The Honest Truth video. And I went into it and I was like such a pretentious brat my first semester. Like if I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys, I took a lot of APs and honors in high school, and I was like part of like the smart kids club in high school, even though I actually wasn't the best student. I gave the illusion that I was a good student. So I had like this heightened sense of ego, and because I went to a school where like some of my close friends went to Stanford right out of high school, I felt like I was on that level, even though like, I clearly wasn't. So I felt like I was too good for community college, which is like kind of really crappy, but also just shows my immaturity regarding higher education at that time. I took way more courses than I should have because I didn't understand the rigor of college. Like I should have taken it easy. I should have just like accepted that this is just like college. You just happen to commute and live at home and there are no dorms. That's the only difference in terms of like academic strength when it comes to a four-year university versus a community college that like I felt like I should have had. I should have had a perspective where it was like, I'm going there to learn and be successful instead of like, oh, I'm too good for this place. I should be at like Harvey Mudd. I should be at NYU and all that stuff. Like I was kind of a brat. No, I was definitely a brat and I didn't give my college or my classes that I was taking the time and respect that it deserved. But I know now, you know, hindsight 2 years too late, that I should have really enjoyed the time that I had there. I wasn't really involved in a lot of clubs until my last semester actually, because I wasn't sure what I was majoring in, so I didn't find my core group of people until the very last semester of community college, which is kind of a bummer. Because now they're all gone and away and I don't get to hang out with them anymore. In other words, I was just a brat. I was a pretentious brat and I wish I wasn't. Honestly, I can say that I had a really good time at community college. And the weird thing is that it's the first time I'm going to be leaving an academic establishment and feel kind of sad. And like, I feel like I'm going to miss Moore Park. I am for sure very ready to leave. I feel like I've grown so much as a person and grown so much as a student there, and at the same time I feel like they still have a lot more to offer me in terms of like clubs and classes, but I know that I can find a different kind of growth at Davis. So I'm not sad about leaving, but also it's like I spent all this time making all these amazing friends and these amazing memories that it's kind of sad to be leaving it. I think a really key thing to note about community college is that if I didn't go to Moorpark, I would not have majored in physics. I would have majored in biology or something, like a science that I wasn't passionate in, or like maybe I would have switched majors into like communications or arts. I don't think that I would be nearly as fulfilled or as satisfied. And I know that I would have been too scared to take a physics class at a four-year university because all of a sudden it's much more expensive. So I'm less willing to try out courses for the sake of trying courses that I had the option to do at community college. I feel like the biggest problem with community college is that a lot of people get stuck there. They get so comfortable with the environment that they're in. A lot of people live at home so they don't have to pay rent. And there's not necessarily a pressure to graduate or to transfer or to leave the same way that there is at a four-year university. So I like busted my ass for 2 years trying to get in and out, and I wish that I had taken a little more time to breathe and a little more time to enjoy my surroundings and my courses and the people who I was with, because the people who I know who are going to Berkeley and like the top and like UCLA and all these amazing universities, not that Davis is not amazing by any means, but the people who are going to the more famous colleges like Stanford are people who have stayed for 3 years rather than two. So they took time to put more space in between their courses, or like maybe start at pre-calculus instead of calculus so they could really get their academic bearings. And I wish that I had done that. Hindsight 2020, I wish I had spaced out my academic experience a little longer, but also I'm not mad that I'm leaving. Because I'm ready for a change, and I feel like I've been ready for this change for a really long time. I just didn't get the opportunity to go and like take that change until now. I have a whole list of advice for community college students up on my blog, but one thing that I specifically want to mention for students who are in California community colleges is take advantage of TAG. So the TAG program is basically a thing where your community college has a contract with a certain UC. I chose mine to be Davis, but you can basically guarantee your admission to that school as long as you maintain like a 2.8 or a 3.2 GPA depending on your major, and you take all the courses that they require you to take for TAG. And that way you don't have to worry about admissions. You just submit your application and you know for a fact that you will be admitted into that school, which takes a lot of pressure out of my chest. I applied to Davis as my TAG, and then I applied to UC San Diego, UC Santa Barbara, Cal Poly SLO, UCLA, and UC Berkeley. SLO Berkeley and LA rejected me, which is fine, and I know that my grades weren't good enough for those three schools, but I got into UC San Diego, UC Santa Barbara, and Davis, and I chose Davis because I just felt like the environment suited me better, and it just felt like home to me in a way that Santa Barbara and San Diego didn't necessarily offer me. And I also liked how small and intimate the physics program was at Davis. At the end of the day, I'm leaving, and I've done well for myself. I didn't necessarily perform to the best of my ability, but I'm happy. I'm happy with where I'm at. I don't have any, you know, academic remorse. I don't have school buyer's remorse. Community college definitely turned me into a better student and a much more respectful student, I guess. As in, I respect the time and effort that my professors put in. I respect academia a lot more. I respect the fact that like general education courses, sure, history might not necessarily have a direct impact on what I'm taking as a physics major, but I feel like it influences me in a positive way that like it builds character, it teaches you resilience, and it also just makes you a more informed person. And I don't think that learning for the sake of learning, again, necessarily is a bad thing. My camera's about to run out of battery, gosh. I just came home from orientation yesterday, so everything's still a little all over the place, but I definitely wanted to film and get this video up before community college started, because I know it starts at Moorpark on August 20th. So, I have a whole list of advice for community college students on my blog, again, like I've said, but the one takeaway that I have from community college is just take it seriously and enjoy the time that you have and enjoy the classes and take time to explore. You're never going to find a school, a university that is as inexpensive or as accessible as community college is. So even if you are already enrolled in a four-year university, take your general education courses at your local community college. That's all I have for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you are attending community college, let me know if it's your first semester or your 20th semester or your quarter. I don't care. Does your country have community college or something like that? I know that it's an experience that is very unique to the United States, but also I haven't done any research in the higher education structure in other countries because I haven't had a reason to. But yeah, let me know. I hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys on Monday. Here's to posting 3 videos every single week and 3 blog posts every single week. Woo! Bye.